Hi there, and welcome to A Level Introduction. This is Media Studies. I'm Mrs. Paul. I'm the Key Stage 5 coordinator for this course. So I just want to talk you through some bits you might be interested in then for this course. Some of the details are here on the screen, so you can be having a look through those that might help you. So why choose media? Of course, because it's brilliant. I've studied media for a really long time, and I absolutely love teaching the subject, as do all the media teachers that work here. It's varied, it's transferable, it's creative, it's theoretical. There are so many skills that you learn throughout that will be beneficial to you. What do you need to be able to take part in this A level? I would say you need to have an opinion. You need to be able to ask questions. So we're going to be talking about big contextual topics like Black Lives Matter, the role of women in the media, the depiction of body types throughout media productions and why that matters, how that has an impact on people, the role of social media and the negatives and positives that go with that kind of technology. So you need to have an opinion on those and be able to question other people and ask questions. Those often lead to some really interesting debates. So you need to be able to hold those debates, listen to other people and be interested and get involved. It would be really helpful if you had an interest in media products. Often we have students who go, well, I don't really read magazines. Well, that's not ideal. Hopefully you there might be some that you don't do as much. Of all the different media forms, I'm not really into video games, but I still have to have an awareness of them. I still have to interact with them. So at the very minimum, you need to have some understanding and interaction with them. And at the most, I would like to think you are a fan of some particular TV shows, that you read magazines regularly, that you have an understanding of different radio stations and shows. So you need to really widen your media knowledge in that way. You do need to be independent and you do need to be a creative somewhat because there is a practical component. You can see that here to just give you that information. There is 70% exam, which is broken into component one and two. And there is a non-exam assessment, which is a piece of coursework. It's usually a couple of bits that create one big product, but we get the brief for that the year that you're in year 12, and we start it in year 12. We use Photoshop, we use some web design tools, there are some filming options. So again, to have some creativity, I don't expect you to be perfect in Photoshop or any of the other editing programs we use, but to have a creative intention, to be able to come up with ideas and give these things a go. If you can use Photoshop, that is really helpful for the course. The combination that media studies works really well with, to be honest, media studies can work with anything because it's such a transferable topics that we cover. Many students in the past have done subjects like photography. That helps in terms of having that deep knowledge of Photoshop. Also, I've had students who do history, philosophy. Sometimes the theory that we study goes quite nicely with those. Film studies is obviously a really key one as well. Some of the analysis skills are really similar. And if you're interested in one, it tends to be quite a lot of our students are interested in both. So that would be another excellent combination of subjects there. But there really hasn't ever been a subject that isn't taken with media. I've had media and PE and students who want to be sports journalists. I've had media and business, people who want to go into opening up their own production house at some point. So there really is, most combinations will work with media. We're very versatile. In terms of going on from here, our students and many of our students who study media at A level go on study at uni, from really, again, very wide pathways from journalism to creative media, which is more design, graphic design, all sorts of things can lead on from this course. So again, the destinations of our students are really varied as well. There are a lot of apprenticeships as well that our students apply for through the BBC, Channel 4. They all run apprenticeships as well. So it doesn't always have to be a university exit from our course. In terms of what you would need academically coming into course, strong skills in English, a strong grade in English will really help you. We do a lot of essay and extended writing when we're analysing our products. Some ICT skills will be beneficial as well, so that you can use the computers efficiently. Maybe some skills in design and subjects like that. You don't have to be good at drama necessarily. You're not standing in front of the camera. We're very much behind it, analysing it, considering how it's been made by other people rather than us having to be in front of the camera. But confidence is always a great thing on any course, which I think drama can sometimes lead to. In terms of preparing for the course, if media A level is a subject that you would like to get more prepared for, there is a reading list available, which you can get from the school's VLE. But also, to give you a general starting point, there are, of course, Educast books that go alongside this course. So we study the Educast A level, but also any books to do with the 1960s. We study several products from then, in terms of what was happening contextually, socially, economically. You could also look at feminism, the study, and the different points in time where feminism has taken on more of a role. You can look at Black Lives Matters. We look at several products that look at diversity and somewhat the lack of it in Hollywood, etc. All of those topics will really help you. And of course, any creative guides that can help you with Photoshop, designing magazines, anything like that is also beneficial as well. But a full reading list is available for you to prepare. Our department is very successful. The last set of grades, 100% pass and 91% A star to C. So our average grade works out at around a B, which is fantastic. Our students study hard, they work hard, they're interested in the subject, as are the teachers, and they get really good grades by working hard and developing those opinions on all the different products we study. There really is a lot of variation. 17 products over the 2 years, and we study some theories as well, which really help us to go further than you would at any GCSE with analysing the meaning behind these products and the issues that these products raise in society. So I hope that gives you a nice introduction to Media A level. It is a fantastic subject with variation, with brilliant teachers, great resources, and we really look forward to welcoming you if you choose this course. Take care.